Spurway back on another How to Paint Your Car Truck video, y'all. This time we're going with a custom three-stage pearl because a lot of folks was requesting on my last How to Paint Your Car vid to do a base coat clear coat because I did a single stage then. Well, we're going to go with a base coat, pearl coat, clear coat the Sprayway. Okay, YouTube, Sprayway finna work on another vehicle. I got this Ford Expedition 1998. This my homeboy, Raw Customs vehicle. He came up here, he want me to go on and hook it up for him. We're gonna go with it like a three-stage pearl on this one here. We're gonna do the door jams and all. Get it right for him. I'm gonna take you a walk around the vehicle. Show you what I gotta do. He got some new headlights he gonna put in. He got like some red flake in it now. It's gonna be a three-stage pearl. Outrageous. We're gonna do the rims too. Need some 24 inches here. This is Car Club, New Era Car Club, repping a 334. Let me show you this here. See that there? We're gonna have to take care of that. Chipped up right here too. Only dent really is these two doors. I don't know if you're able to see it, but it's kinda, it's pushed in right here. And it's pushed out at the top, so. It ain't too bad, but it's a little work up in here. But y'all know Sprayway gonna get them right. I'm gonna start stripping it down, then I'm gonna cut you back on. Okay, I done got the truck pulled back to the back. I'm gonna get ready to start stripping everything down. For this custom paint we're gonna put on it. Like I said before, it's gonna be like a three-stage pearl. We're going with two different pearls on this one. But I'm finna start taking all the molding off. Probably start Scotch-Brite my door jams. We'll be right back. Okay, I got the truck pretty much stripped down like I want it. I got the tail lights out, side molding. Headlights. What I'm about to do now, I'm finna get my favorite tool, my DA. Y'all probably see this in every video that I do. Better get you one, come in handy. But I'm finna DA the whole truck. But first I'm gonna get this painted on pinstripe up. Cause you want a feather edge, you don't wanna leave it on because you gonna have a line in your paint. So I gotta go on and get that up. I'ma use, I think, 180. That should take care of that. You can see I got some of it DA'd already. But what I mean about feather edge is you don't want to feel no line. It want to be like a feather. Feel like a feather. Real smooth transition. See right here? Where the pinstripe was, I could feel the line. You might can see this part here. It's got to come down a little bit more because I still feel a little line. But that's what you want to do. All right, I got Mr. Roe out here with me. He putting his hands in it. You know, I usually work by myself, but he said he want to go on and get his truck done. So I'm going to go and let him take you around the truck, show him what he done did. He learning.
All right, what's up, YouTube? As you know, this is Roe Customs. I'm up here with my man, Sprayway Customs. And he been showing me how to use this DA here. You know, showing me how to knock down the feather edge where that pinstripe was. So that's what I've been doing, you know. I think it's been coming along pretty good. You know, he ain't complaining. So I mean, hey, Sprayway do perfection, so it must be coming along pretty good. So yeah, that's what we got so far.
All right, we're going to go on and finish on up. We'll cut you back on. I got the truck pulled in the booth now. It's pretty much DA'd down all the way around. Take you around on the other side. I haven't DA'd it yet. I haven't did anything to these two doors here because I got some body work I need to take care of first. You can see it's pushed in down through there. It's knocked out up here. So I'm gonna have to knock this in and pull this part here out. But what I'm finna do now with it, I got me a grinder with a flap disc on it. I'm gonna go ahead and knock all this down to bare metal. So I can get it right. Y'all see him, YouTube. I got Raw Customs putting to work. He said he wanted done, so he got to get with it. Say what's up, Raw.
What's up, YouTube?
My repair area is grinded down to bare metal. Gonna get ready and pull this area here out. See, can you see it? What I'm talking about. I'm finna pull it out. Then look like this spot here might need to be knocked in, son. And over here, This here gonna have to be knocked in. And I'm gonna go ahead and fill it up with some Bondo glass. How you can tell if your panel's straight here. See, I got a piece of hardwood, a straight edge. You see the gaps in between here and there, also down here. I'm gonna have to fill it on up, build it up right there. I'm finna get ready to shoot my first coat of primer. I got it pretty much smooth right now. When I lay my 2K primer on it, it's gonna show me all my imperfections. Right now you can't really tell. But I'm finna blow it off with the blower. Then I'm gonna go on and shoot the primer on it. Just on my spot, my repair spot. Done pulled the truck out the booth. We pretty much done all the body work, sanded everything down. We're finna get ready to clean the booth out and clean the truck off, take it back up in there and prime it up. We had went on and shaved this back windshield wipe off. We got the truck all masked up. We're finna get ready to shoot the primer. We wiped it down with some soap and water. We put the moldings back on. Got the entire truck primed up. I laid 3 coats of prime on it. It's ready for that guide coat now. Laid down real good. So let me get to the top and show you the top. Okay, it's time for the guide coat. What I got, some cheap flat black. Picked it up from Walmart. It's all you need, flat paint. What you wanna do, shake it up real good. And you just wanna mist it on. You don't wanna put it on that heavy. Just mist it on. See that though? That's all you need. Okay, we're on to the next step. I got my maroon scotch brake. We're doing the door jams now. I'm getting ready for paint. Only thing you want to do is scuff them up so the paint will stick. If it's factory paint, that's all you need is a maroon scotch brake. I'm trying to feather edge this here. This is where the primer blew back into the door jam. Feather edge it on out. That's all you need. Got the jams masked up, ready to lay some paint on them. Making sure everything clean and wiped down before I start spraying it. Went on and taped this off because I don't want no overspray on the inside. Got this here taped off also. I'm gonna go ahead and spray this little part here, because once you shut the doors, I ain't gonna be able to get it where I need it to be when I spray the truck. So I'm gonna get that now. Got this here too, taped off. I'm gonna go ahead and do this part too. Also back in the back. Like I said before, he going with a custom mix color. But for his base, it's gonna be a red, jalapeno red. Where I got this jalapeno red from, I was watching CJ's video over there at Countryside Club, and he put it on his bike, and I showed it to my partner, and he said that's what he wants. So that's how he came up with that. But he gonna use it as a 3-stage base coat. He got some pearl here. Deep red pearl, then he got some more pearl. It's red also. I'm gonna put it in my inner coat clear. This is what it's for, mixing pearls, flakes, and powder. Then he also got some candy black metal flake. He still ain't decided if he wanted to, if he wanted to go with this yet. But he better hurry up because I'm finna get ready to start spraying. But we're gonna see how it's gonna look. Cause I don't even know right now. Mixing all this together. But we're gonna see. There's three coats of base here. Then they go with the pearl next. Custom mixed pearl. It's not really putting out the correct color through this camera. Let's get ready to lay the pearl. all at the same time, film and spray. Show them that overspray here, the overspray from that paint. Spray Way and Raw got that boy at the booth. We done cleaned down the top, sprayed it off. We're finna get ready and wet sand it. We're gonna shoot our black base coat, metallic. We're gonna go ahead and shoot that first. We got it jammed on out all the way around. Show you what the jams look like. Okay, we got the truck masked up. We finna go ahead and spray the top. Black metallic. See, we got it masked up all the way around. Keep that overspray down. We also, I'm gonna go ahead and wet sand this part back here because we're gonna put a decal right here. I'm gonna paint it metallic black, then I'm gonna put the decal right there. Then I'm gonna paint over that, then I'm gonna pull the decal up. Then I'm going to clear it. Y'all will see later on down the line what I'm talking about. On both sides. We done pulled it out the booth. We finna get ready and wet sand it. We got some soap and water. I think we're gonna go with 500 on the wet sand. We done did the top black. Painted these sides here because we're gonna put a decal right here. And we're gonna spray over it, then we're gonna pull the decal up on both sides. Also, we're gonna do something with the hood too. But we're gonna go ahead and wet sand it. Then we're gonna cut you back on. And Rob, we're working overtime out here. Y'all see it out there. Nightfall. What you think about it, Raw?
Man, let me tell you something. Boy, this wet sand is something serious for me. This is my first time ever doing it, but Sprayway's showing me how to do it, though. It's coming along. It's sure as hell, though.
Let me show you what I'm doing right here. See right here? I ain't sanded this part here yet. It got to come down. You still can see the guide coat, the black paint. Just bring that on down. It need to look like this here. Smooth. I already undid that part back there. Little spot right here, I had to put some glaze and put on it. But we getting it though. It's taking time. It's all about that prep. I done took the hood off the truck. I'm finna go ahead and spray the black metallic. Where I said I'm gonna have a design right up in here. Also on the other side. Then I'm gonna put a Ford, I'm gonna paint a Ford sign right here. So I'm gonna go ahead and paint that. So when I get ready to paint the truck, I can just mask that up. Then paint everything at the same time. I went on and laid the base coat and the clear down. I just put two coats of clear because I'm going to go ahead and wet sand this. I just laid it down for protection. You can see I didn't do the whole hood. I just did where the black going to be at. And the middle is going to be red. And on the end, it's going to be red. And I'm going to have a Ford sign right here in the middle. I also sprayed the grill. He had got a billet grill. I went on and sprayed it black. I'm going to let this go on and dry overnight. Then I'm going to come back out here and wet sand this. Then I'm gonna get ready and mask up for my lines and my decal. The hood is sanded down with 600. I'm finna get ready and start doing my masking. I'm gonna put the line somewhere along here, along the body line. Then I'm gonna put my decal on. Also start masking the truck off. I use paper, plastic, foam tape. I use a little everything on this masking here. This is the foam tape I'm using. This for to keep your paint line down and it make your masking go a lot faster too. See, if you mask it off with tape, you have a paint line. But this foam tape, it'll just blow up in there and feather edge. I'm gonna take you a walk around the truck, show you some of the masking. I just put plastic in here just to keep down the dry spots from the overspray. You see right here, I got the molding pulled back so I can get some paint up in there. I won't have no paint line. It'll look like factory paint job. And then here, I just put foam tape. I still gotta finish this back off. I'm gonna put a decal here and on the other side too. I got the fender flares pulled out so I can get paint down up in that. Same way up here, I got it wrapped in plastic. See on this tape, there's a line right there. I just put it behind the line. I don't know if you can see it or not. Got this all masked off because that paint will blow. It'll blow through this crack and you'll have dry spots on your door jams. I got the top plastic. I'm gonna go on and finish up wrapping up this masking. Then I'm gonna go on and start doing my decal masking. You wanna get you some wax and grease remover. I got some prep all by Clean Strip. Make sure you wipe it down real good. Because I've been using this for my masking platform and I got adhesive all over it. So you want to wipe it down real good, get all that oil and grease adhesive off of it before you start masking it. These are my decals here, I'm going to show you. I just got some Fords. I'm going to put these two on the side. I'm going to put this one here in the middle over there. You see, I put an arrow in the center of the hood right here. Just lay my decal down. Press it down real good. Once you get it pressed down real good, you can just peel this little plastic covering up. That's it. And when I paint the red, wherever you see white, it's gonna be black. I'm gonna go ahead and stripe this part here on out. I'm gonna cut you back on. Okay, I got my fine line tape here. Went on and did my lines with it. I followed the body line. Now what I gotta do, I gotta go back right here and cut this out. Because it's gonna be red right here, back up through there, and back up through there. Okay, I gotta cut out. I'm gonna go ahead and mask it on up, the inside of it. Because I don't want no red paint to get on that. So I'm gonna mask this up. And I think I'll be ready. Okay, I got the truck all masked up. I'm ready to shoot that base now. I'm finna go ahead and hit it with some wax and grease remover. Get all these fingerprints and the oil off our hands for masking. Go ahead and clean that up. Then after that, I'm gonna hit it with a tack cloth, a dry tack. Once I hit it with the tack cloth, I'm going to blow it off also with the gun before I start spraying it. Because you want a nice, clean surface. Okay, I done laid down 3 coats of base. This jalapeno red here. I think it laid down pretty smooth myself. What I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna go ahead and tack this off, dry tack. Then I'll be ready to shoot my custom mixed pearl.
There were 3 of them. Man, is that gonna be enough?
Yeah, this shit go a long way, man.
I'll go with 4 of them. I like pearlish. I like heavy. It don't look like it's gonna run out, so. Much at 5.
See, we might open the plates in here too. Because the plates is like a pearl.
How many are you?
4.
Yeah, I mixed that up. That's turning red too, ain't it?
Straight.
I had 2 on now.
I think four of them on this. It ain't gonna kill it. But we're gonna see if we're gonna put.
Most of that on the bullshit. Shit that thick as a motherfucker. You had shot some video of this stuff? Wow, that shit does look good. You right. Pull that bitch up. Let me see that motherfucker.
Yeah, maybe you can see it. Put this up.
All right, throw some more of that.
Put some more in.
Hell yeah. Might have to go up the doses on everything.
That shit look like a damn rose gold.
That's three. Hit four. And then hit. Then hit that other shit.
I'm going to put the flakes in here too. Because this is like a perk.
You got to have like a big tip to spray them flakes?
No, it's mini flakes. Huh?
I see everybody be saying something about flake
tips. Like these, and like, shit. It's like a perk though, man. It's so thin. Like a rose gold, yeah.
Well, that red up underneath it should bring it back out.
Yeah, but it's, you know, it's translucent. It ain't that color, see.
Yeah.
I probably cut the parts of it off anyway.
Well, I'm going to turn it well now. Go ahead and put some flakes in there. I'll stop. I thought I was recording the first motherfucker time. I'm sure I was. I was looking at record. What's up? Making this custom paint. What?
Put two on.
Yeah, two to go.
That was good.
Yeah. Shit, that's what's up. It's all candle. I'm trying, yo. We mixing paint now. We about to spray some shit. We done primed the truck down. All the truck primed and everything. We done taped it off. And we gonna start spraying the dough jams. That'll be the first thing we do. My homeboy said, see him in the Cadillac.
You know, I ain't gonna see it, man.
Hold on. He got his hands dirty. He can hear you, though.
Hey, big homie.
I ain't gonna sell it.
He said he ain't gonna sell it. He said he gonna keep it ride smooth and good.
Okay, I just got through laying down 3 coats of that custom mixed pearl. You can't really get a view of it how you need to get it because my booth's so small. But it's looking good though. I'm finna get ready and unmask all my decals and my stripes up here, up front. So I can go ahead and shoot that wet plus. Might can see the pearls and the black flakes. Okay, I'm finna get ready to unmask it. It's dry to the touch. It don't take long to dry. You wanna be real careful. You wanna peel away from the paint. Well, this part here don't matter because it's on this masking here is on top of Madison face. Y'all can kinda see what I was going for now. I'm gonna have to get some wax and grease remover and get this sticky stuff up, that adhesive from this tape, because it's been sitting up. It ain't been sitting up too long, but I think maybe 8 hours. But it ain't no big deal though. Wax and grease remover, take it right on up. I'm gonna go on and get this done. I'm gonna cut you back on. All right, I got this billet grill. I'm finna get ready to install it. I gotta come up with a way to attach it to the old front. What I'm thinking about doing is, let me see here. I'm gonna go ahead and grind this off, cut them off with a cutting wheel. Then I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna fiberglass me some bolts, something I can bolt down to this here. I'm gonna fiberglass me some up in here. So what I'm gonna have to do, I'm gonna have to take my flap disc. I'm gonna clean out all this here, scuff it up so some fiberglass will stick to it on both sides. I got both sides grinded down with the flap disc. Now what I'm finna do, I'm finna mix up some bundle glass. Then I'ma put it in place so I can hold it in place before I fiberglass it. Cause that bundle glass, it'll dry real fast, so once it's in place, I can fiberglass around it. You see I got my bolts attached with bundle glass. Then I cut me some pieces of fiberglass mat out and put it around it. Now I'm gonna soak it in resin on both sides. Fiberglass and resin down. It should hold it pretty good now. Gonna be a quick video of the finished truck. I couldn't give it a good wash like I wanted to because the owner was pushing for time. We finished putting everything back on the truck around 3 a.m. so he was ready to hit the highway. You might see dust and overspray on the windows, but I wanted to get a video before he left.
DM, ballin', tryna get VIP, we bout it. I see you, I see you. We not friendly, don't get started. You offended, oops, I'm sorry. I see you.